Greetings, Benjamin J., the Victrola Guy, with another in the series. Well, picked up a El Cheapo microphone today at the thrift store, and wanted to test it to see how it works making electric recordings on the cylinder phonograph. So I've got the microphone plugged into the preamp, preamp is plugged into the amp, amp is plugged into the driver, driver is plugged onto the Canophonic voice recorder, and the Canophonic voice recorder, of course, is on the electric cylinder phonograph. So I've got a black wax napkin ring cylinder on the machine. We're going to do a quick recording and see what kind of recording we can get with a microphone. Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, making a test recording on the electric cylinder phonograph using a microphone. Picked this microphone up for a dollar at a thrift store today, and surprisingly, it had much better tone than the mic I was using. So I thought I would just do a quick test and see how it would sound doing a direct cylinder recording. So I've got the microphone plugged into the preamp is plugged into the amp is plugged into the driver is on the recorder, and the recorder is on the electric cylinder phonograph. Recording on a black wax napkin ring cylinder, about 3 inches long. This is one of those broken cylinders, and this is when they come in handy. You can use them for doing test recordings without tying up a good cylinder. So in any case, just doing a quick test recording on the electric cylinder phonograph. This is a microphone recording, which eliminates any problem using a horn. Also allows you to set up a microphone and record direct to a wax cylinder, just as if you were going to record to a disc. So recording on the electric cylinder phonograph. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching. All right, we kill our input. Remove the driver, remove the recorder, blow off the swarf, install a Model C reproducer. I'll play this back through a Morning Glory. That'll give us an idea of if it's rich or full or shallow or tinny. All right, so get everything set up here. Let's check the camera. All right, so here's the recording we just did with a microphone.
Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, making a test recording on the electric cylinder phonograph using a microphone. Picked this microphone up for a dollar at a thrift store today, and surprisingly, it had much better tone than the mic I was using. So I thought I would just do a quick test to see how it would sound doing a direct cylinder recording. So I've got the microphone plugged into the preamp. The preamp is plugged into the amp. The amp is plugged into the driver. The driver is on the recorder, and the recorder is on the electric cylinder phonograph. Recording on a black wax napkin ring cylinder, about 3 inches long. This is one of those broken cylinders, and this is when they come in handy. You can use them for doing test recordings without tying up a good cylinder. So in any case, just doing a quick test recording on the electric cylinder phonograph. This is a microphone recording, which eliminates any problem using a horn. Also allows you to set up a microphone and record direct to a wax cylinder, just as if you were going to record to a disc. So recording on the electric cylinder phonograph. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.
All right. Well, as you can see, it works. And this is with absolute junk. I mean, this is a dollar. And it's probably from a kid's tape recorder from the 1970s, or a cassette recorder, perhaps. And about the cheapest preamp you could find, Radio Shack. It runs on a 9-volt battery. A guitar amplifier, the Canophonic driver, and the Canophonic recorder. Recording on an electric cylinder phonograph directly from a microphone. So, as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.